Here we go again. Same old shit, dog, just a different day. In this video, we're talking about logical matrices. This is a follow-up to our discussion of logical scalars and logical vectors. A logical matrix is an expression in MATLAB that produces an M by N matrix-valued output where each entry in that matrix is a logical scalar. Remember, just like in logical scalars and logical vectors, the concept of a logical matrix or a two-dimensional logical array is that every single entry is a logical scalar that encodes a truth value of a corresponding statement. Let's take a look at how to create logical matrices in MATLAB. On screen here, we see an example of a 3x3 matrix. We're going to store this using the numeric data class called double. That's the default numeric data class in MATLAB. To do this, we'll do the entry by entry definition, 1, 0, negative 1, semicolon, 0, 2, negative 1, semicolon, 1, 0, 0. Go ahead and push enter. Now let's create a logical matrix using the logical function that we've seen in previous videos. We'll say that LA, the logical version of A, is equal to logical of A. Remember, MATLAB does a test. This data is stored as numeric data. In other words, this is a double, here's another double, here's a third double. What MATLAB does in the test for logical is it takes each individual entry and asks a simple question. Is the value stored in a particular entry zero or is it non-zero? For zero entries, we're going to switch the numeric zero to a logical zero. In other words, we say false, there's no data stored here. For non-zero entries in numerical data, we're going to say that when those non-zero entries appear, the test is going to be true and we'll replace the non-zero entry with a logical one value. In other words, if A is a numeric array with three rows and three columns, LA is the logical array that stores the test, the individual entry is non-zero. If the test is true, we produce a logical one. If the test is false, we produce a logical zero. We store the results as a logical scalar in the associated entry of that matrix. Let's take a look at a second example of how to create logical matrices. To do this, we'll store random integer matrices. So we'll start by setting B equal to rand I. In this situation, rand I means random integer valued matrices. The first entry of this function is going to be the upper bound for the whole numbers we want to choose. So in this case, let's choose 6, and we'll let this be a 4x4 matrix. In other words, MATLAB is going to populate this 4x4 matrix with random integers evenly distributed between 1 and 6. That's what we see here. If I now subtract away from that 3 times 1s, and we'll let this 1s be 4x4, notice that this matrix 3 times 1s is a matrix of all 3s, so that literally shifts every entry of my random matrix down by 3, which takes the lowest entry 6 and shifts it down by 3 to 3. It takes the entry 1 and shifts it down by 3 to negative 3. So notice all of these range between negative 2 and 3. If I wanted an even distribution on either side, so maybe we go from negative 2 up to 2, well, notice negative 2, negative 1, 0, 1, 2. That's actually 5 integers. So let's go back to this call. And instead of starting at 6, let's start at 5. This matrix is going to be a random matrix with entries between negative 2 and 2. Notice there are 2 zeros. If I now say LB is equal to logical of B, MATLAB is going to test the following statement. The entry is non-zero. If that is true, it will produce in the exact same location a 1. If that is false, in other words, the entry is 0, it will produce a 0 and store the result as a logical matrix, which is a, in this case, 4x4 array, each of whose entries is a logical scalar. We can run such a test again with a different matrix. Every time I call rand I, this is a pseudo-random integer generator. So now if I say LB is equal to, logical of B, notice it's a different pattern because I have a different random matrix. That's exactly what I see here. That is an automated way to create logical matrices from integer-valued numeric matrices. With that, let's conclude this video. We'll do a quick review of different terminology that we've used when discussing logical data in MATLAB. Remember that a scalar is a one-by-one array. A logical scalar is a one-by-one array whose value is either true or false, 0 or 1. Those are stored using 8 bits of memory, or 1 byte. A row vector is a 1 by n array where n can be greater than or equal to 1, so all scalars are row vectors, but not all row vectors are scalars. We'll talk about that in the next video. The point of the matter is, though, a logical row vector is a 1 by n array where each entry is a logical scalar. A column vector is an m by 1 array where m is greater than or equal to 1. In other words, all scalars are column vectors, but not all column vectors are scalars. A logical column vector is a column vector where each individual entry is a logical scalar. A vector is a general way to refer to any structure that has either one row or one column. In other words, when I just say vector, I'm not sure if I'm talking about a row vector, a column vector, or an individual scalar. We say that a matrix is an m by n array where m is greater than or equal to 1 and n might be greater than or equal to 1. All vectors are matrices, but not all matrices are vectors. So too, all scalars are vectors, therefore all scalars are matrices, but not all matrices are scalars. In the next video, we're going to introduce some notation to let us distinguish between these sets. For now, let's recall that a logical matrix is an m by n array, each of whose entries is a logical scalar. So far, in order to generate logical data, we've seen logical scalars, logical row vectors, logical column vectors, and logical matrices, each of whose we call using the logical function. The individual entries of any of those data structures are either 0 if the test is false, or 1 if the test is true for the individual entry that we're focused on. Let's go ahead and explore some clarifying terminology in the next video. I'll see you there.